Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. In this video we will talk about EV Trip Planner. Now you must be thinking, what is EV Trip Planner? So EV Trip Planner is a software that will basically suggest you your route, as well as it will basically suggest you the range you can drive considering your vehicle situation and considering your driving styles. So the first thing that we'll talk about is how it will help you. So it will help you in route planning. It will basically suggest you different kind of ways or different kind of path you can choose for your destination from point A to point B, and considering on these suggestions will be considering different kind of things. So now you can choose from one of those suggestions, and it your vehicle will be driven on those kind of situation or different. You will be getting a navigation about your chosen path. Now second one, it will help you in the range. It will basically let you know about the range, and you will basically get to know about the knowledge you can drive from the range that you are left in your vehicle. Third thing is the charging prices. Fourth one is the finding, book and pre-ordering the charging station, and the entertainment. These three things will basically let you know about the charging prices, as well as you can basically consider or advance book your slot before reaching that charging point. And the fifth one is the entertainment, which is one of the most important thing when you are traveling from point A to point B, considering upon the journey you are traveling or the kilometers that you are driving. Now we will talk about those who are planning to develop these kind of softwares. So the first thing that you must consider is about the car, and in this you have different kind of points. We have different kind of points that I have listed over here. The first one is the car model, driving style, weight of the car, current range and the nominal battery capacity. So if you're talking about the EV Trip Planner, it's basically a suggestion of path, or you can say it can basically suggest the smallest path you can consider when you are traveling from point A to point B, as well as it will give you a suggestion, or you can say information about your range that you can drive. So for about car, if you're talking about how and what are the things that you must consider about car before predicting the range and before predicting the route that a customer must follow, that are car model, driving style, weight of the passenger or weight of the car, and the fourth one is the current range, and fifth one is the nominal battery capacity. Because in the car, if you're talking about, these things will basically help you in predicting the range at a very good percentage, and it will be helping you in predicting the range at a very good percent. Now route condition, what are the route condition and how route condition will basically hamper or change the range will basically let you know and should must consider in your software. First one is inside and outside temperature. Second one is the average speed. Third one is the traffic situation, and the last one is the charging. And this charging, we have different points such as plug type, charging infrastructure and amenities. Now different customer have different kind of choices, different kind of amenities they require when they're planning for their route. So that's why it would be beneficial if you consider amenities and charging infrastructure in your software. And inside and outside temperature will basically let you know or let you predict the better range or better route for your customer. Now in this, while ending this video, I just want to give you a few tips that can make your software upper hand, or can basically give your software an upper hand considering all the EV planners that are already in the market. So the things that you must consider that will give your software an extra push. First one is pay for charging using your infotainment and mobile phone. Second one is monitoring real-time battery health. Third one is a voice integration, which is required by 67% of the people according to the market survey. Fourth one is encouraging community contribution that will help you in real-time monitoring. Fifth one is inform on the range loss on idle, that will basically give you a confidence or a customer or confidence that your software is basically helping them in considering and planning their route in a better way. Last one is the customer report and personalized statistics. A lot of EV trip planners lack in this area. They basically don't consider customer's feedback or the personal statistics, because a lot of EV trip planners are basically lacking in this area. And if your software have these kind of things, it will give your software an extra niche or extra push in the market comparing to the already EV trip planners that are in the market. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any kind of suggestion or any kind of feedback, feel free to comment down below. Till then, peace.